Hi friends, today I discuss rhombus. So today I discuss some special type of a parallelogram in which first is rhombus. So the rhombus is a type of parallelogram. Rhombus is a type of parallelogram which have equal sides, which have all equal sides. All equal sides. So rhombus has all property of a parallelogram and also a property all equal sides. If I draw a parallelogram, if I draw a rhombus, then looks like this diagram. This is a rhombus in which all sides are equal. All sides are equal. So in rhombus, all property of a parallelogram, and one more property, that's all sides, all equal sides. All equal sides. One more important property of a rhombus is diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular bisector of one another. Perpendicular bisector of one another. I can prove this by very easy method. I take a rhombus which named as A, B, C and D. Draw two diagonals A, B, C and D. Because rhombus is a parallelogram, then both diagonals bisect each other. So I can say OA is equal to OC. If I take this point O, then OA is equal to OC. And OB is equal to OD. OB is equal to OD. Now in triangle AOD and triangle COD. AOD and COD. Let's say AO equal to CO. AO equal to CO, because in parallelogram two diagonals bisects each other, and AD equal to CD. AD equal to CD, because in rhombus AD equal to CD, because rhombus all sides are equal. Because all sides are equal. Now the next is OD equal to OD. This is common side. So we can say triangle AOD is congruent to triangle COD. So we can say that angle AOD is equal to angle COD is equal to 90 degrees. So I prove this property, diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular bisector of one another. Now the next type of parallelogram is rectangle. Next type of parallelogram is rectangle. Rectangle is also parallelogram. Rectangle is a parallelogram with equal angles. Rectangle is a parallelogram with equal angles. And if each angles are equal, if each angle are equal in rectangle, and if I assume each angle are x, then according to the property of all and all sum of all interior angle of a quadrilateral is 360. So we can say 4x equal to 360, so x equal to 90 degree. So we can also say that rectangle is a parallelogram with equal angle equal to 90 degree. So also we can say rectangle is a parallelogram in which every angle is a right angle. Every angle is a right angle, because rectangle is also a parallelogram. So have opposite sides of equal length. Opposite sides of equal length. And diagonals bisect each other. And diagonals bisect each other. These two properties also present in rectangle. Now discuss in second page. Now one more property of rectangle, which is diagonals of a rectangle. Diagonals of a rectangle are of equal length. Are of equal length. Now discuss, if I draw a rectangle, if I draw a rectangle A, B, C and D, then if this is a, if this is a rectangle A, B, C, D, then in triangle ABC and ABD, ABC and ABD, then we can say that AB equal to AB common side and BC equal to AD, BC equal to AD, because opposite sides are equal in rectangle. And one more, angle A equal to angle B equal to 90 degree, because each angle in a rectangle is 90 degree, then we can say by SAS rule or side angle side rule, the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. Then we can say that AC is equal to BD. So the diagonals of a rectangle are of equal length. Equal length. Now I take the third special type of parallelogram is square. Square is a rectangle with equal side. Square is a rectangle with equal sides. So now square also have all property of rectangle. And rectangle property, first is each angle 90. First rectangle property is each angle 90. Second rectangle property is opposite sides are equal. Third rectangle property is diagonals are equal. So square have also all property of rectangle with one more property, which is all sides are equal. Now I draw a square. We can say BELT. BELT. This is a square. And in a square, BL is a diagonal and ET is also a diagonal. So this is a square, and it is in case of square, one more property which state as diagonals of a square are perpendicular bisector. Are perpendicular bisector of each other. Perpendicular bisector of each other. If this is intersection point, it's called O. Then if you can say OA equal to OC, or we can say OB equal to OL, and by this congruence property I can also prove this property diagonals of a square are perpendicular bisector of each other. So I discuss all type of parallelogram and all property of parallelogram. Now let's take some example in next page. Now this is the problem. Rent is a rectangle and find the value of x, and also given this OR is 2x plus 4 and this OT is 3x plus 1. And now if you remind a property of rectangle which states at this OT is half of the diagonal TE, so we can say OT is half of the TE, and we can also say that OR is the half of diagonal RN, half of the diagonal RN. So diagonals are equal in this case. So diagonals are equal in this case because by the property of rectangle, both diagonals of a rectangle are equal. So we can say that this OT is equal to OR, and by putting the value of OT 3x plus 1 and OR 2x plus 4, solve this equation 3x minus 2x equal to 4 minus 1, so x is equal to 3 centimeter. So x is equal to 3 centimeters. This is your required answer. So I hope you understand all type of parallelogram, all property, taking some example. So please download the Scholar Learning app, and if you already download this, then enjoy learning. Thanks for watching this video.